Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I'm here with a video about applying the distinct keyword to your JPQL, but not your SQL query. So here's today's question. I'm using a query with a join fetch clause to load parent entities with all their child entities. The JPQL query requires the distinct keyword to return each parent only once. I don't want that distinct in the SQL query. How can I tell Hibernate to use the distinct only in the JPQL query? JPA's join fetch clause provides a great and easy to use way to load an entity and its lazy associations within one query. From a performance point of view, this is much better than using additional queries to initialize the associations. That's especially the case if you load a list of entities. But if you use this clause for the first time, you might be surprised that the list of entities returned by the getResultList method contains duplicates. The SQL query joins the associated database records, and the result set consists of a combination of a parent record with each child record. Unfortunately, Hibernate doesn't resolve these duplicates by default. Let's have a look at an example. Here's an example of a JPQL query with a join fetch clause. As you can see in the log statements, the list of authors contains as many references to the author 1 and the author 2 entities as they have written books. Each of these references points to the same entity object, which contains a fully initialized list of related book entities. That's probably not the result that the author of this code expected. You can add the distinct keyword to your query to tell Hibernate to return each author entity only once. But if you run this test case again, you can see that Hibernate also adds the distinct keyword to the SQL query. This is often not intended and might result in an inefficient database query. Since Hibernate 5.2, you can prevent Hibernate from adding the distinct keyword to the SQL statement by setting the query hint hibernate.query.passDistinctThrough to false. The easiest way to set this hint is to use the constant defined in Hibernate's org.hibernate.jpa.queryHints and org.hibernate.annotations.queryHints class. As you can see in the log messages, Hibernate no longer adds the distinct keyword to the SQL statement. It now only applies it to the SQL result set and returns each author entity only once. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!